I am Carolyn Austin, and I am very honored to be here this evening to represent the VFW Ladies Auxiliary Post number 3201 of Minneapolis and have the privilege to honor our military veterans. I want to thank our graceful principal and staff and the students for coming here tonight for letting us have a few moments for this special presentation. We also want to let you know that we have cards available, and if you know of that we may not know about, we'd really like for you to fill the information out and then get that back to a VFW member, or you can drop them off at the post office. Thank you. The VFW Ladies Auxiliary has been working with Quilts of Honor organization for almost a year now in preparing and making quilts. Tonight, we would like to honor 11 veterans of Ottawa County by presenting them with a quilt of appreciation for their service to our nation. As I call their names, if you would please come forward, and if you cannot, we will come to you. Also, if I should give incorrect information as to when and where you served, please correct me and forgive me. Our first veteran tonight is Mr. Darrell Sanders. Mr. Sanders will be 101 on the 20th of this month. He was stationed in Louisiana, at Fort Sill, Oklahoma, Scotland, England, Germany, and Fort Smith, Arkansas. Mr. DeMurl Eckert, M.D. Mr. Eckert is 99 years old. He was in the military between 1943 and 1945, also between 1953 and 1954. He served in World War II, was in the South Pacific, and New Guinea, Australia. Mr. Max Holsley. Mr. Holsley served in the Army between 1952 and 1954. He was stationed at Fort Sill, Oklahoma. Missouri, and the National Guard. Mr. Frank McCready. Mr. McCready served in the Army between 1944 and 1946 and was stationed in the Philippines. Mr. Whitley served in the Army, Air Force, between 1942 and 1946. He was stationed in Fort Leavenworth, Kansas, Fort Logan, Colorado, and served in World War II. Next, we have Mr. Emery Berry. Mr. Berry served in the Army between 1953 and 1955 and was stationed in Fort Gordon. Mr. Luther served in the Air Force between 1942 and 1944, stationed at Fort Hood, Texas, Colorado, Tucson, Arizona, served in World War II, and was in the National Guard. Mr. Lee served in the Air Force between 1942 and 1945. He served in World War II and was in England. He was stationed at Ridgewell Air Force Base near London during the time of the bombing in London and D-Day. Next is Mr. Robert Merrifield. Served in the Navy between 1946 and 1968. He was stationed in San Diego, California, within the Korean War and Vietnam. He was in the Pacific Ocean aboard the USS aircraft carrier Naval Air Center. the service that they have given to us and our nation. Let's stand and give a one more round of applause.
Thank you. strong and precious child, my daddy has been sent to fight. The only place I shall see his face is in my dreams at night. He will be gone too many days for my young mind to keep track. I may be sad, but I am proud. My daddy's got your back.
I am a caring mother. My son has gone to war. My mind is filled with worries that I have never known before. Every day I try to keep my thoughts from turning black. I may be sad, but I am proud. My son has gone to death.
I am a strong and loving wife when the husband seems to go. There are times I am terrified in ways most never know. I bite my lip and force a smile as I watch my husband pack. My heart may break, but I am proud. My husband's got your back.
I am a soldier, serving proudly, standing tall. I fight for freedom, yours and mine, body and freedom's call. I do my job, but none of the things that sometimes ask, say a prayer, I come home, it's me that's got your back.
Step in Time is a song honoring our armed forces. Please stand when your military branch is recognized. The order of songs is Army, Air Force, Navy, Marines, and Coast Guard.
Thousands, thousands, seven in time to the call of their country. Thousands, thousands, seven in time. Thank you. Winston Churchill said, "We sleep safely at night because rough men stand ready to visit violence on those who are harmless."
Even though we long for peace and justice, we still have to be prepared for war. Freedom is a privilege we enjoy because of veterans like you. You have had our backs for over 200 years. Thank you and good night. Please stand for the